and welcome to CPHS-12 Haunted Halloween Hill. My name is Count to 10, and we have a chilling show for you.
And I'm Elvira, Mistress of the Dark. Well, Halloween is my favorite holiday. You can keep your Christmas and your Easter, and we're here to make your Halloween even better than ever.
That's right. And tonight we have for you little ghosts and goblins, spooky Halloween stories, terrifying pumpkin carving, and Halloween safety tips.
And we'll also show you what the best-dressed trick-or-treaters will be wearing in our fashion segment, and also chic makeup tricks done by our own precious little Angelique.
Love that, Angelique.
Hi, my name's Fred. I've had enough of this. Let's get on with the show!
Today we have some ghosts and goblins with us from Howard Krell School. Are you kids all ready for Halloween?
Yeah!
All right. Are any of you going to be a witch for Halloween? Are you? Well, that's great, because today we're going to hear a story about Humbug Witch. Do any of you know what humbug means? Do you think you know? What do you think it means? It means somebody's kind of tricky. Yeah. Well, this little witch thought she was pretty tricky, okay? So our story is called Humbug Witch. There was this witch, and all of her was little, except her nose, which was very, very big. She had two crooked teeth and long, stringy red hair. In fact, it was so long, she kept tripping over it. She wore a slightly squashed, tall, black, pointed hat, like witches always wear, orange gloves, a hand-knit black wool shawl, an old plaid apron, red and white striped stockings, and funny-looking black shoes with gold buckles on them. She had a good, sturdy broom and a black cat named Fred.
Hi, boys and girls. We're here today to show you how to carve a pumpkin.
Now it's the Halloween season. We know that a lot of you are going to be wanting to carve pumpkins, and we just want to talk to you a little bit today about the safe way to do that and a number of different ways you can do that safely at home.
There's lots of things that we can use the pumpkin seeds for, and we'll be talking about those, but we're going to get started right now on carving our pumpkins.
Probably two ways you could start carving your pumpkins. Sometimes people like to draw and trace out on the top first where they're going to do the cutting. Drew, or maybe I could use the mask that you had on yours.
Yes, uh-oh.
It's right in front of the bucket there.
Here it is.
Great. I wonder if it would fit over the eyes. Oh, I like that. Makes it look a lot scarier.
Oh, that scares me. Woo!
And I was lucky. The eyes fit right where the mask eyes are.
That's because you planned it.
No, I didn't. I was real lucky. I could have marked them beforehand. Well, there we go.
You know, sometimes the top doesn't fit there.
It's hard to find out which way it goes, huh?
Ah, very good.
All right.
Maybe we could put this down here so we could show the boys and girls our pumpkins.
What a nice start. I think I'd want to work on mine a little bit more sometime.
Yes, you could spend a lot of time and do a real, real good job.
Well, I hope that will help your parents put a bite into your jack-o'-lantern.
Count, you kill me.
I do.
But now, lovely Angelique is going to demonstrate Halloween makeup.
She did mine. Thanks a lot, Angelique. For an angel, huh?
Now we have for you the latest fashions from Lendzions of Port Huron and Transylvania. after this important safety message.
Telling you to take a bite out of crime. Oh, they must have wrote it with me in mind. Oh.
Against the beat.
And now it's time to tell my tale. As I said, my name is Count to Ten. And I'm glad you boys and girls are all here this afternoon to listen to this tale. Do any of you remember the story of Ichabod Crane?
Yes.
He lived in the legend-filled valley of the Hudson River long time ago. And one night, while returning home through the woods upon his skittish horse named Gunpowder, he encountered a most terrifying sight. In the dark shadow of the grove, on the margin of the brook, he beheld something huge, misshapen, black, and towering. It stirred not, but seemed to gather up in the gloom, like some gigantic monster ready to spring upon the traveler. His hair rose upon his head in terror. What was to be done? To turn and fly now was too late. Summoning up, therefore, a show of courage, he demanded in a stammering accent, "Who are you?" He received no reply. He repeated his demand in a still more agitated voice. Still, there was no answer. Once more, he nudged the sides of his inflexible horse, Gunpowder, and shutting his eyes, broke forth involuntarily into a church song. Just then, the shadowy object put itself into motion, and with a scramble and a bound, stood right in front of him in the middle of the road. So what do you think about that, kids? Pretty terrifying tale, wasn't it?
Yeah.
No? Well, that scared me, and I'm the Count. Well, I hope you all enjoyed your day here, and you enjoyed your treats, and you enjoyed your stories. Well, thanks for being with us today. And have a good Halloween.
Do you know what is almost here?
Why, yes, Halloween.
And what should we watch out for on that night?
The house giving the most candy?
No, we should be watching out for other things.
Oh, like the kids with big bags so we can steal some of their candy.
Is that all you think of, candy?
Why, yes.
And what will you do with all this candy once you get it?
Eat it.
That's what I figured. Well, while you're out stuffing your face with candy, I hope you're going to be watching out for yourself. And by following a few rules, you'll be fine. Like, one, never go out alone. Two, if you wear a mask, make sure you can breathe and see out of it. Only go places where you know the people at their homes. Always carry a flashlight so you won't trip over something or get hit by a car. The cars will be able to see you then. And in the most important rule that we always follow all year round is that you don't talk to strangers. And if you remember all that, Halloween night will be great and fun. And unlike some people that eat all their candy on the first night, don't eat all your candy right away. Make sure that you save it for next week so you don't get a stomach ache, remember?
Oh, okay.
Yeah, remember the time you ate all the fingertips too? How did you feel then?
Not so good.
Oh, I didn't think so. Well, the fact's the same here. Got it?
Got it.
Great. Now remember, Halloween can be fun, but also can be very dangerous. Do take the proper precautions.
That's right. And from all of us at CPHS-12, the Port Huron Area School District, and Lendzions,
have a safe and happy Halloween.